Let us begin discussing goal weight, BMI, how should I go about doing this? I'm feeling all kinds of stress. So you've been losing weight, right? You've gotten to a healthier place, and maybe your doctor or a certain weight loss group has said you need to be at this weight to be considered good, right? This is your goal weight. This is what you're supposed to be. Well, here's the deal. Any weight you lose and keep off makes you a winner of this game, because statistically speaking, the chances of regain are high for those that lose weight. So if that means you weighing 140 pounds is correct, right, based on the BMI chart and the standards, but you're currently weighing 160 and you've lost 100 pounds to get there, better to keep off the 100 pounds and weigh 160 than to push to lose 20 more, struggle, sabotage, feel like a failure, and gain weight. I see this all the time. So what I actually focus on is less the BMI chart, which is what a lot of these organizations use in order to determine your quote unquote goal weight. I go based on waist measurements. For example, I think it was last month, the end of June 2018, I did my waist measurement. It was 30 inches, right? And I'm working currently on fat loss. Let's just say I get into the 29 range. My waist is really in a good place. When you look at the risk factors of a waist of 35 inches or higher, right? But my body weight on that day was 155 pounds, which technically is not the correct weight I should be based on the BMI chart, even though I have lots of muscle, even though I'm small, even though I've got a great waist measurement. That's what the BMI chart says. So I can struggle and try and get down to 145, 140. I can do that. But by all medical markers, including what my doctor says, I'm in good health. So here's what you want to think of when you're picking a goal weight. One, is it maintainable? Not achievable. I can literally go do crazy things right now. I could get down to 145. I have no doubt. I could go sweat it out. I could go on eating nothing but lettuce, right? We could do these things to achieve a certain weight. But I also know I like to eat food. I like to do strength training. There's things I enjoy doing. And so I don't think I would keep it there if I took those measures to lose it. So it's not maintainable based on those methods. Number one. Number two, I check my waist measurement. I check my body composition. You can do this with a DEXA scan, bod pod, clippers, assuming you don't have a tremendous amount of loose skin like I do. And really, I personally, if I were to prioritize a hierarchy of importance, is one, can you maintain it? And you've lost weight, you're in a better medical position, right? Most doctors actually would much rather you settle in at a slightly higher weight than the BMI chart if you can keep it off. So talk to your doctor, make sure your medical markers are in a good place. Two, I always check waist to hip ratios. I'm posting some articles below. I encourage you to check it out so you can see what I'm talking about. The next thing before the BMI chart, this is all prior to BMI chart. The next thing I would start to do is look at getting a body composition test done, DEXA scan, bod pod, something where they are doing a fat to lean mass ratio. So if you get that done and you find out, hey, I'm 26% body fat, right? I'm in a really good place for my age, my height, my weight. Then even if the scale weight doesn't reflect what the BMI chart says, I would go based on that. So all of these things to me are far above the BMI chart. And I even posted a couple articles in there about the BMI chart and where the flaws are. So I feel like if we educate ourselves on some better markers, one, two, realize it's about living your life. I love in the, Dr. Yanni Friedhoff says it's your best weight. It's the weight that you can continue to maintain and live your best life. So when you're struggling with what maintenance weight should I select, ask yourself, is my medical markers in a better position? Do I have a good waist to hip ratio? Is my lean mass versus body fat in a good position, in a good place? Is this a weight I can maintain? Have I made progress and can I maintain this weight? Ask yourself all those questions before deferring to the BMI chart. And if you're attending a weight loss program that sets a goal weight for you based on the BMI chart, I would encourage you to talk to your doctor and maybe look at getting a letter from the doctor stating that there might be a better weight for you based on height, weight, how much you weigh. Another thing to consider when setting a goal weight is, what is the lowest weight you've ever been in your adult life? Now, if you're female post having children, or maybe within menopause, and oftentimes this is eye-opening for a lot of my coaching clients, where they'll say, well, the lowest weight I've ever been since having my kids is 180 pounds. And maybe right now they're at 250. Our goal is to get you back to the lowest adult weight you've been, which is 180. It may be far away from where the BMI chart says, but that's step number one. You got to baby step your way wherever you want to go. So really start to evaluate this differently. Start to take in other markers as opposed to the BMI chart. I'm not saying it's something we totally should do away with, but I do think it needs a heck of a lot of revamping. So I just want to share that with you because I saw some confusion about goal weight. All right, you have a fabulous day. I'll talk to you soon.